Yeah, oh, of course, yeah.
Найк никогда не был в этой студии, для него это интересный опыт. Сейчас хочу поработать с микрофоном, производство из них и есть российское, и есть зарубежное. Сейчас мы, он как раз будет выбирать, который из них лучше.
Now the first thing, welcome to our wonderful players, Andre and Evgenia.
Андрей и Евгения, это наш человек, который сегодня работает с вами.
And they very kindly agreed to be guinea pigs for us. They have come in to this studio for the first time and started to practice here. And Andre, you've set up right next to the piano there. Now, for an engineer, do we think this is a good? Is this going to be easy for us to record it here? Just stand where you're going to, where you're going to perform and play a little bit.
А когда они пришли сюда сегодня и начали немного заниматься, они встали так, как им удобно. Сейчас Майк спрашивает, как вы думаете, удобно ли для инженеров находиться в таком виде, пока их часто нет?
Obviously, we're going to get violin and piano, and it's really important to get make sure we're happy with the sound of both on all the microphones that we use.
Но когда мы будем вставлять микрофон, это очень важно, чтобы расставить так, чтобы услышать и скрипку, и фортепиано.
So there's lots of ways of recording violin and piano. Some people like some violinists like to stand here, like a concert. If you stand here. More in the piano. This is what happens in a concert, isn't it?
Иногда, ну, некоторые исполнители стоят здесь же в углу, ну, собственно, в крыле рояля, как стоят на концерте.
Usually.
Обычно.
Not always.
Не всегда.
You do your concert like this. Yeah. Some people do it like this as well. But for watching, that's okay for watching, isn't it? I think for the audience. But for recording, we don't have to worry about the audience. We can choose where it is.
Но so, когда вы работаете в студии, вам не нужно ставить или там просить музыканта встать как нужно для публики. То есть здесь возможны варианты.
Yeah. So the most important thing is to get a position where these guys are happy, but we can also get a really good sound.
И наилучшая позиция, когда оба музыканта стоят так, что им комфортно было бы играть. Но дальше это уже ваша задача.
And we might experiment with some different places, but since they have started in this position, I think we should try and record it here first and see how it goes.
Вот здесь возможно какие-то варианты, потом спросить, как это переставить и так далее. Но сейчас вот в таком варианте можно попробовать начать их записывать, чтобы потом найти какие-то варианты.
But I do feel that with Andre here, he's a bit close to the wall. I would like to move the piano this way a little bit, first of all. Mm-hmm. So you've got more space here. Okay. So can we just move the piano that way a little bit? Sorry. So now, when you stand where you're going to play, let's see where your sound is going. Just listen to a little bit of sound. Perhaps just play the beginning in the room. Thank you. So, the best sound probably from this violin is going to be playing this way, because he's standing like this, so it's going out that way. So if we put microphones round here, we're not going to be in the best position for the violin, are we? We'd agree with that. But what's really important about choosing where we put our microphones is that we're going to get piano and violin on every microphone.
Сейчас очень важно выбрать также позицию, где будет стоять микрофон и фортепиано.
And the way that Beethoven, they're going to be playing Beethoven. The way that he's written, it's a big piano part. He's written for a much smaller instrument than this, so this is really the wrong instrument. And it's a beautiful instrument, but it's not what Beethoven in his composition wrote for. So as the engineer, we have to consider that we are slightly fighting the problem that we've got the wrong instrument here. So let's consider how we might put some microphones around. Now, the other issue is that we've got to think about stereo, left and right. Now, normally on a recording, a violin and piano recording, you probably want the violin not exactly in the center. That's the way we normally do it. I think it's sort of traditional. Probably not exactly in the center. Probably slightly. In a concert, I mean, the normal, you're doing it this way. So if you were the audience and you were looking at the stage, usually you might have the violin to one side there or to one side there, but not in the middle. So where we put our microphones is going to decide what the stereo is when we hear it in there. Yeah? So let's think, if we come somewhere like this, the piano is going to be on the right and the violin is going to be on the left, So when you start to place your microphones, you need to consider how the stereo is going to come out and make your angles so that it doesn't sound too extreme for a CD. Okay, so let's just put some of these microphones up in a position and we'll record a bit and we'll see what the differences are. Now that's an introduction to how we're going to work, but I want to record some of these microphones because the next issue is that the microphones themselves all sound different. So what I'm not being very clear about introducing it, but what I'm trying to make you think about is there's all these different things that affect how the end result will be. It's the position of the players, it's where they are in the studio, and it's where we put the microphones, and it's what microphones we use, and then it's how we mount them. So all these things make a difference.
Получается, для записи важны четыре вещи. Первое, как стоят исполнители. Второе, акустические характеристики студии. Качество и производство микрофонов. И соединило в одно, да.
Okay, so that's... So if he's standing on the left, we'll make our recording so that the violin is a bit left of the middle and the piano is a little bit to the right to start off with. We'll try and do that. So let's put all our microphones somewhere sort of matched. If you just give me a hand. We've got, shall we tell you what the microphones are? Maybe that's a good thing. Let's go through them one by one. Probably you might need to help us here. So we've got we've set it up so we've got some microphones almost in the same place, so we can compare the microphones. So here we've got, these are Sennheiser MKH20. You've got a brush with lots of different paints, and you can choose the colour. And all of these microphones are a little bit different colour. And some of them might be good for this violin, and some of them might not be so good. What is this violin?
Некоторые могут быть хороши для этой конкретной.
But if you're recording a Stradivarius, for example, they are very, very bright. And when you're close to them, they're great for concertos, but they're very, very bright to record.
Это скрипка.
Stradivarius.
Stradivarius. Да, она очень яркая для записи.
No, but if you were, for example.
Скорее всего, чех копии.
But I mean, there's huge difference in the instruments. And that's another thing that affects the sound, you know. So if you,
sorry. Yeah,
leave these entirely for now. Okay, so that, and the next two microphones we've got this, because you can adjust. By adjusting that, you can make a small adjustment here, it can make a huge difference to the width in the sound and the phase. Mm-hmm. Phase? We've got phase? Yes. So with this, you don't have any control like that. It's fixed.
Mm-hmm.
And this, in a way, this is the most pure way, isn't it? This is the most pure microphone here, because it's absolutely designed in alignment, and it's not adjusting, you know, it just does what it says on the tin, in a way. So we've got, and then the other microphones we've got two more Royer figure of eights. These are figure of eights, aren't they? Oh, we can. It's quite a coloured room sound. Let's go through them. These are the Sennheisers. These are the Sennheiser omnidirectionals. And those are the Sherps. And remember, they're in exactly the same place, they're about an inch apart. So that's the Sherps MK21s. And that's the Sennheisers. So if you listen to the piano on the Sennheisers compared to the Sherps, there's a lot less definition on the Sennheisers than there is on the Sherps. This is the Sherps, and that's the Sennheisers. More bottom end on the Sennheisers. Can you hear the difference in the bass? Quite different. So on the violin, that's the Sherps. There's more brilliance on the violin.
Excuse me, please. Is there any pan setup?
No, I just pan them left and right for now, so we can just hear. Because I'm trying to decide what microphones actually have the nicest sound before we even think about where we tune them. They're on cardioid, so you hear less of the room. So there's much less of the room. They're too close for the violin, of course. But the quality of sound is very different. So compare those. That's the 170s to the 21s. 21s are more natural, actually, aren't they? Much more natural violin sound. Pretty good, actually. not incredibly bright, are they? But
yeah,
they're quite nice. So they're supposed to be like this. very different, aren't they? So these are in the same position as these mics. Very, very different sound. So those Schertz microphones, remember, these are the Omni ones. I told you they have a slight lift at the top. They're a bit brighter. Quite good for the piano. Russian ones now again. Oh, they've stopped. Here it is. That's the Russian ones. And that's the Schertz ones. Interesting. And then we've got the ribbon ones. So the Russian ribbon ones. These are the Russian ribbon ones. Violin sound on those. Can you hear the quality of the violin sounds? Very different on these compared to those. Wow, it's like chalk and cheese, and they're in the same place, aren't they? They're virtually in the same place. Interesting, isn't it? How much? So the Royers, which is those ones, have got quite a nasal, quite a middly sound, haven't they? Initial reactions, who likes what? anyone have a preference to, in terms of the character of the sound?
Schertz Omnis.
Schertz,
the yes. Schertz Omnis? Mm-hmm. The ones with the bright ones or the not the 21s?
No, cross ones.
Not the 21s?
Yes.
The 21s. These are the Schertz.
Yes. Almost natural.
They're good microphones. I'll tell you why I think they're very good. It's because they're clean. They're clean on the piano. The bottom end of the piano is quite clean, isn't it? Compared to the other Schertz. That's the other Schertz. Gain's right. Thank you very much. Thank you. Take a few minutes. We're going to do some playbacks. Great. So, the great advantage. So, that's the Schertz on this with the bright. Quite natural on the violin, isn't it? Anyone else got a preference? Anyone else? Anyone else? Or did you all agree that you like the 21s most?
I was impressed how bright actually the ribbon, last ribbon ones.
The last ribbon ones, yeah. The royal ones. The panic, they're in the wrong position, aren't they? But, so let's compare those to the 21s. So we have one vote for the 21s, and let's just do a comparison. So these are the royal ribbon ones. This is the Schertz 21s. Not the Royers. There's something about these Royers, actually, that gives it a kind of old-fashioned sound, isn't it? It's almost a vintage sound. And they're not. They don't have a sort of very electronic-y top. They're probably quite. They probably cut off quite low down, actually. Okay. And you can use that. You know, certainly with a violin, one of the things is you do get a lot of. You can on some violins, you get a lot of treble that is not necessarily good on the CD. You know, it can be too bright. So it's not a bad idea. If you think that this is the kind of sound you're going to go for, then you can say, well, okay, I'm going to work on these and try and put them in a better place. Let's compare those to the stereo version again. That's the stereo Royer. I'll to me, it's a bit far away, isn't it? Yeah, it's further away for a start. We can't quite. But it doesn't. Maybe create our own acoustic, maybe add a bit. I think in a small studio like this, where you've got a lot of close reflections, probably your safest bet is to be closer, slightly closer than you think. Because you can always add acoustic, but you can never take it off. Mm-hmm. So it's better to be on the closer side. Mm-hmm. Is there any of these that we think we completely discount? Does anyone think there's some microphones that are just hopeless?
Maybe let's compare the 21 with the Russian.
And maybe we quite like these Russian DPA, so maybe we'll sort of discard some of the other ones and try and get a better position for them. Mm-hmm. And it might be worth, I mean, what do we think about the balance? Piano to violin balance. Is it going to work in this position? It's actually not too much piano, funnily enough. Because usually that's the problem with Beethoven. It's actually not that much. We could even try and open the lid and see if we can get away with the lid open, which would be nice. Perhaps we should try a little bit with the lid open, just to see whether we can control it. Let's go and make a couple of adjustments then. We'll wander into the studio and we'll have a word with the... So what I normally do is, maybe I've got three options for something like this, and I've set them all up, and then I'll do a first listen, and then I'll come out and try and make all three options better. I might think, well, it's good, I like the sound of it, but it's not in the right place, it's too far away, there's too much room on it, so it needs to be quite a bit closer. How much pain have you got? We've got a good stand here. So we could try and. So I can't stop it picking up from behind. It's picking up this way and that way in equal measure. So the only way you can get less acoustic on it is to come closer to the sound source. You're not actually getting less acoustic, but you're changing the ratio between the front and the back, aren't you? Because we're nearer, so therefore. I'll have a better gain. I'll have more gain from the front, and I'll have less from the back. Mm-hmm. So let's try that. So, and the other ones we liked. We liked the these words and the Sherps 21s. We liked. Mm-hmm. For me, the 21s are always a good safe microphone. You know, if you can't get anything to work, 21s nearly always will work. Mm-hmm. Did English translate that or? You weren't listening, were you? But I think, you know, we quite like the sound. At the moment, we're really listening to the sound. That's good like that. Right, so we've changed quite a few things. We've moved our microphone positions and we've opened the lid of the piano. So let's go and let's record. Can we do the same bit? I like it on the violin. This is the Royer Stereo microphone. The Royer Stereo. And we moved it, didn't we? We moved it quite a bit further forward. So the sound of the studio is much less obvious, isn't it? I mean, this sounds more like the kind of thing we need. But that's a bit ill-defined. The piano's a bit ill-defined. Of course, we could fix that later on. Interesting that the opening the lid hasn't made it too big. Okay, let's hear the 21s now. I've made them slightly wider because I thought they were a bit closed in. Quite diffuse on this, isn't it?
And the violin is less defined.
Because it's too, you think, because I moved it wider? He's not standing there. And then we've got the, we've you've got the Royer stereo, the Royer figure of eight. These are the two Royer figure of eights. And remember, so if you decided that you really liked this, the tonal quality of these microphones, and you felt there wasn't quite enough definition on the piano, it's very easy to bring in piano mics, just to add a bit. I'm going to compare these to the Sharps on this. 21s. The Sharps on this. You can feel the lower frequencies are better on these than the 21s. The 21s always to me have the same kind of sound. They're slightly lacking around sort of 300 Hz ish, around that frequency. And they have a slight boost around 6 kHz, you know, which is usually very helpful, but not always. And the reason that's helpful is because a lot of console halls need a little bit of brilliance added, and a lot of them have a little bit much mud in the lower end. And so 21s do the opposite of that. And that's why 21s are so consistent in big halls. They're very, very good microphones.
Why don't we bring it closer? Just try and get this a little bit.
He doesn't move too much. Okay, so can we try and get these now in a good position? That would work. That we're doing now?
Yeah.
Well, on this one, we're trying to get a better piano pickup because we didn't think it was that good. You've changed the positions of the 21s, haven't you? Mm-hmm. These two. So the way you've changed them now, the piano... rather extreme left right, isn't it? He's very much on the left now. I mean, to me, that's too extreme for stereo. He's probably a bit close to it now. Okay, let's hear the 21s. So I'll tell you what, I'm going to stop them. Okay, guys, I'm just going to stop you for a second, if you don't mind. I'm just going to make a quick adjustment, please. So,